This is John McLaughlin Outdoors in its fifth big season. John McLaughlin Outdoors is brought to you by Berkeley Trilene Line and Berkeley Power Bait, Regency Company Marine, your Central Iowa tracker dealer, The Tackle Shack, with personal service the big stores can't offer, and by Nature's Art Gallery, specializing in art for the outdoors enthusiast.
We're back on the water again with Lou and Larry from KGGO. It's been about a year absence. We've had you on the show. I think we're ready to try again.
And we're back at the same place where this guy almost caught a world record fish.
That's why we're here. Just down that pike a couple hundred yards. He lost the big one, and today's going to be the day, right?
And you know, legitimately, that was the first time I had ever fished. And this is the second. I thought you probably taught me everything there is to know about fishing the first time out. So yeah, I'm ready to go get the big one now.
The big question today is, we have some flooding down here. What kind of bait to use? You guys have any ideas?
We're just gonna lure them. Actually, what we've done today is we're gonna prove that making noise does attract fish. We brought a cassette player. We got a couple of different kinds of music. We brought some Van Halen. We brought some Garth. And we also brought some Kippadada to sing the fish song.
What Van Halen, awesome. Jump as the fish come
up? Of course, that's exactly it. And of course, I don't care what kind of bait we use, just so it's plastic.
Okay.
These hands don't touch worms.
Well, we've done a lot of research as to what baits work best. I don't know if you can see that one there.
The Hawkeye.
The Hawkeye, yeah. I'm sure this'll be it.
And for the Iowa State person.
There we go.
This is the true test. Football was not a true test.
Okay,
this will be the true test.
Iowa State's had their difficulty, the last 10 years?
Yeah, right. But forget competition. It's the Hawkeye against the Cyclone. This will prove once and for all who's really the better outdoors person.
We'll find out in just a moment.
Now let's see here. The simple procedure for taking this off is you grab his lower lip to immobilize him. First, you have to find his eyes to figure out which one his lower lip is.
All right, you're halfway there.
And then, this is an easy one.
In through the outdoor or something.
I had no trouble removing these hooks. I'm having a little more difficulty this year. Well, look who rings up another. The Johnny Mac.
We're not keeping score up here, though.
No. You're the host, and it would be rude, and you're the pro.
Oh my.
He's running.
Now, you know, I could pull it up now. I'm just trying to be a little dramatic here with this.
Trying to, what we call, do the Virgil Ward treatment.
What would you say?
Solid 5-pounder.
5 pounds? 5 pounds? What I'm seeing is closer to 12 or 15.
Another new state record.
Oh, wait a second.
Let out a little line there, you can.
Boy, you can hear John's lure over here.
Yeah, this one.
This weighs more than a 16-pound bowling ball. Don't tell me this is only 5 pounds. Not buying that.
Whatever.
Wait, so.
There we go.
Nice branch there. Oh no, he's got a branch that's swimming.
He's running. He's running. Under the boat. Come out. Wow, how about that, Mr. Morgan? Oh, this is an ugly one.
Whoa,
big jumps.
There we go.
You know, guys, I don't think we should fool around keeping score. It's more fun just to camaraderie and fish.
That's right.
See, and what lure did he choose? The Iowa State lure. Good going.
See you, bud.
Come on up here.
There we go, baby. There we go, we got one too, Larry.
Ooh. Might have a good one there.
Just a fighter.
Well, I guess.
He's saying this isn't a good one, John? Huh?
They're all quality fish.
That's what I'm thinking.
There we go.
Two happy anglers with with their thumb stuck in a bass's mouth.
Yeah, what could be better than this, huh, buddy?
The Rock and Roll Bassmasters, that's what they call us.
Thanks for coming out here with us today.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, John.
Great fun.
I'm going to take these home and prove that we did catch something.
You know it.
Nice to, yeah.
What was that final score?
Don't remember. Don't remember.
Final score, the Cyclones 13, the Hawkeyes 8.
And we'll be back with more right after this. I knew the Cyclones could finally win something.
Lake Vermilion in northeast Minnesota near Ely is a sportsman's paradise featuring miles of water and an unlimited amount of structure, including islands, underwater rock reefs, weed beds, and more. and few people know Vermilion, especially the east half of the lake, like John Schoondyke. When John offered to guide us for some smallmouth bass fishing, well, we couldn't resist.
Well, down home in Iowa now, it's probably 90 degrees or so, so we decided to come north where it's always fairly cool, at least out on the lake, Lake Vermilion up in northeast Minnesota with John Schoondyke. And I know this is one of your favorite spots in the whole world up here, isn't it?
Yeah, I used to come up here 5, 6, 7 times a year. Anymore, I don't get up here maybe 3, but I could retire here very easily.
Yeah, that'd be all right. It's just a huge lake, plenty of islands, a lot of rock, nice water.
There's 365 islands on this lake.
And what is it, about 30 miles long?
Something like that, I don't know for sure. 30, 40, something like that. Oh, there's one.
What do we got?
Probably a little smallie off that rock shelf there, but he's not very big. Man, he's staying deep. Maybe he's a little bit better than I thought he was.
That's not a bad one.
There we go. All right, catch him in the air.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was under you, I figured it'd fall off probably. That's not a bad fish.
He's poundy, pound and a half. They quit flopping here.
Yeah, they're good fighters.
Yeah. That's a nice fish.
Why don't you hang on to that a second? We gotta get some pictures here.
My trophy smallmouth.
Get her way out here, so
there we go.
Well, not quite that much. Okay. All right, one more here.
Okay.
All right, thank you very much.
You bet.
Let that one get back in there.
Goodbye,
good
buddy.
Shape. Oh. Do you know the real reason I come up here, don't you?
What's that?
The chocolate malts at the Wayside Cafe.
They make good malts.
Yeah, they do. That's almost worth a 7-hour drive just to come up here for those.
My wife says, what do you eat? I've never lost a pound up here. Come up here and gain 5 pounds.
It's not hard to do.
Yeah, I need it too.
After Marge rounded us up some burgers and shakes at the Wayside Cafe on the shores of Lake Vermilion, it was back out for some more smallmouth action.
Well, we'll just try this little baby again.
Maybe things are turning on here after dinner.
I hope so.
What's that water temperature now, down there by my gear shift?
Yeah, it's just 64. It's cooling down a little bit. That doesn't hurt anything. 69 is boiling fish in this lake.
67 is about as warm as I saw it today.
Jump out of the river. He picked out a cow and he had it for dinner.